And thank you everybody for coming for our Sunday workouts with Illinois Squash. We've been doing these since April, and it's been really amazing lineup of local and guest pros. So today we have Laura Massaro, who is former world number one. And I was just looking at her website. When she retired, she had 23 PSA tour titles to her name. So it's just a real honor to have you, and really excited. PSA actually posted on their social media. So I was just really excited to see that public service announcement. And I actually dreamt that, Obama joined our workout. I'm just hoping, that people are enjoying coming together on Sundays and having squash, during lockdown, and staying fit and healthy and together virtually. So just thank you so much, Laura, and I'll turn it over to you. And if you wanted to share any words about squash and how it's going, and then, we're ready to sweat.
Thanks for having me on. And I've had a little sneaky look at some of the previous videos, mainly just to get a feel and an idea of the sort of work that you guys have been doing. It's looked tough, but really good variety as well. So I kind of wanted to start a little bit with a little bit of a different feel to a couple of the other videos that I watched, in terms of just talking a little bit around sort of my philosophy of movement, which might be a slightly different take because I'm now on the coaching side of things, and I started to look a little bit more in depth at why maybe I kind of won as much as I did, and maybe I didn't appreciate that fully while I was playing. I sort of feel like I appreciate it a little bit more now I'm trying to teach other people how to play. So the thing that's popped up during retirement has been around the philosophy of movement and my coach, David Pearson, and how he basically taught me to be efficient around the court. And what you see at, kind of at junior amateur level is a lot of running and hitting. And I think when you move well, you move in more of a patterned way. It creates efficiency of movement and it creates rhythm, which means that hopefully you're still strong and got energy at the end of matches. And I think that when I was playing in big events and you get to those big semis, big finals, the last thing you need is sort of that kind of heaviness in your legs because you've worked so hard to get there. It was a little bit more about that. And so what I wanted to do was, obviously I'm going to take you guys through a workout, that's why I'm here, but what I wanted to do was kind of really get your mind switched on to some squash type movements, especially now hopefully we can all get on court a little bit more in the next few weeks. So it was more around, everything I'm going to do today is a little bit more based around how that will help you on court, how it will activate and move you in certain ways. So before we sort of get started with the mobility, this is the bit where I'm going to talk a bit more, and then we're going to obviously get going into the workout. I kind of wanted, if you've got a bit of space behind you or a mat, kind of just wanted to go through a little bit of this philosophy that I'm talking about. So firstly, the one thing I think that I see a lot when I'm coaching players is they fly into the corners. And then there's this movement of landing the foot, if you can see me, and then it comes a little bit up onto the toe. And you can already see, as soon as I've done that, I've gone wobbly. And so it was thinking about kind of trying to be aware of, even when we're doing the workout and we're lunging, trying to think about going heel toe, because that just creates that steady base, really, and the full base. And so you hit the heel comes in, and I'm sure everyone's seen still shots of all the pros where they're throwing that leg out and the heel goes in first. What's important is then not to come up onto the toe and to keep all of that weight over your feet. And the other thing that links into that is as you go heel toe, this back leg, I think a lot of the time isn't used enough to get you out. So it's sort of like, rather than giving that front leg all of the weight and then having to use the front leg to get you out, you effectively want to push out so you could hold your weight on that back leg if you wanted to. So when we start to get into the workout and I'm telling you to lunge or jump or whatever it is we're going to do, I'm going to be kind of reminding you of this heel toe, activate the back leg, get in, get out, try to be efficient, try to be light, and staying tall. So a lot of what I see as well is people really squatting on the tee and then they want to run to the ball really quickly, and it's all very, very quaddy, very, very glutey, and really, really hard on the legs. But if you think about staying tall and light, not only can you go up for a volley at any time, but you can move quick. And I think the pros, and in any sport, they almost look like they're going slow when they're actually going really, really quick. And so just to get you all going a bit, the one thing I just wanted to show you is, if everybody can just come into a split squat position, like, or a lunge position, sort of where you would be in a squash. And what I want you to do is sort of bend that back leg down. And then I want you to just think about giving up with the hips. So from here, you're in a nice stable position. If I say give up, what I mean by that is just sink. And all of your weight goes into the floor. And so when we're talking about the squash movement, if I then say to you, just activate, push the floor away, it's only a little movement, but you've got strength and you've got height. And so when you think about, right, if we give up there again, everyone sink down, try to get out of that lunge from there. How hard it is. All of your weight's in the floor and in your quads. Now, lunge out again, give up, sink in, just give up, and then reactivate. So you've got some tension, and now try and get out. So I don't know how, sort of a little example, I don't know how that felt, but hopefully it felt lighter and easier. And so when I'm talking about lunging in and you go flying into the forehand front corner or backhand when you get back on court, you really feel like you can use that energy to get out, and therefore you're doing less work, less running, less flying into the corners and all of that. So that's going to be the overall theme of the workout. So when I say hips up, I mean don't sink. When I say chest up, shoulders up, it's so that from that position you could, if you needed to, go up for a volley. And when I say sort of like heel toe, you know what all these pointers mean now. So
big, yeah, little differences results in big differences.
Yeah, and this is the thing, like the best players in the world, the ones that move freely and flow and in rhythm, it's not a coincidence that they come through in five games at the end of matches. It's not a coincidence that they are still fresh. And you're like, as even as a fellow pro, you're like, how are they looking so good in the final in a fifth game? And they've had, you know, hours and hours under their belt through the week. So I think that was the British Open for me stood out, I think, with that more than anything. When I beat Raneem and then she came back from 2-0 down against Shabini, I was so tired in the final, but I kind of just, I just went back to my movement. Honestly, I just went back to my rhythm and my flow. And that was what got me through that final. And I you know, genuinely would have said if my movement wasn't good, I wouldn't have won that British Open. So just as that kind of extreme example, there. So that's the talking done. Now the work begins. So really big believer in massive amount of like warming up, mobility, firing up. I watched James's. So for anyone who did James's, same sort of thing. So we're going to start with a little glute circuit. So if everyone comes down onto their mat. And what we're going to do, we're going to start on our side, if you can all see me there. And we're going to start with a glute clamp. So you're going to, feet are bent, feet are in line with the bum, and you're just going to lift that top leg away from the bottom leg. So I can't actually see myself, so I'm hoping you guys can see me.
Down a bit. Keep going.
So you're gonna really focus on sort of keeping firing up with the glute. So what I don't want to see is sort of like an opening of the hips. You're really just using your glute to lift that leg away from the top leg. So obviously the reason for this is everything I just talked about is about firing up the glutes, firing up the legs and the hips, so that you can activate, so that you can get off the ball, so you can hold your weight when you go in and we're all activated up. Next one is straighten that top leg and just lift it up and down. So straight leg raise. So hopefully we'll do probably 2 minutes each side. And I was probably doing this 3 to 4 times a week. and probably building up to about 3 minutes each leg. So if 2 minutes feels like a lot, then stick with that and then try and add a 30 second rep on, and then maybe another one to reach up. Next one is little mini circles. So same direction, just keep going. So hopefully everyone's starting to feel a little burn now. Let's switch direction. And in the next one, which is coming up in 5 seconds, is toe up to the ceiling. So now, toe up to the ceiling, toe down to the floor. But really focus on just turning the glute and the leg. So what I don't want to see is sort of that, again, rocking open with the hips so that you can get that motion. So just go as with the range you've got, and hopefully you can all feel that glute working to twist open and close. 5 seconds. Good stuff, that's 2 minutes. Switch legs. So starting again with the clam type action. Off we go. Top leg away from the bottom leg. Keep that glute activated. And just keep working. Ten seconds. I saw Olivia Fechter did a workout for you guys, and her glute circuit's a killer. Straight leg raise. Don't think mine's quite as bad as that. I did that and I was even struggling to walk the next day. Good stuff, keep going. Just push the range as far as you've got, just up and down. Five seconds.
Is the foot flexed or does it matter?
I don't think it matters too much. Let's go with the circles. I think it's actually, now you said that, this one feels better with the foot kind of pointed up towards you, pulled up towards you if you can. Just activates everything a little bit better. Let's switch direction. And then when we've done this one, we're coming into our toe up, toe down. Now, so toe up, toe down. Really focus on using the leg to move that foot. I know how easy it is to try to push the range by moving the hips backwards and forwards, but keep your hips still.
One side is easier than the other.
Yeah, that's true. I think one side's always a bit more flexible as well than the other. And stop there. Well done. Everyone feel a bit of a burn going on?
I definitely felt it.
Good stuff. Okay. So the next one we're going to do is just, we're going to come into a little bit more movement stuff now, a little bit more mobility type stuff. So we're going to come down onto our mat. I want you to have your knee in front of you in a 90 degree angle and the back knee the exact same. So this is a great hip opener. So what we're going to do is we're going to lean over the front shin. We're going to lean over the side of the thigh. And then you're going to reach back towards the back toe. And you're just going to keep going round. And this is one that I think you'll definitely find one side's a little easier than the other. And you know, if you've got tight hips, you might not be able to get fully down to the floor. You're just really pushing it to the edge of your individual range. And if again, you do this a few times a week, you're trying to sort of start to get into down to where I am, perhaps down towards the floor a little bit more. Okay, let's switch sides. So over the front shin, making sure that that back knee is also a 90 degree angle. Over the side and reach back. We'll go around 5 times. This is 3. last time round. There we go. Okay, so the next one's like same sort of position. So, but I want you to turn more, well, you can stay where you are actually, just so that I can show you. So 90 degrees, 90 degrees. You're gonna rock over that front shin. And then if you can, without your hands, you're gonna rock the legs over. So you end up in 90-90 on the other side and then reach down over the other side of the front shin. If that's too hard, that's fine. Just put your hands down behind and then that'll create a little bit more space within the hips for you to be able to get that movement. But ideally, hands off and rotate and rock over from one side to the other. So really opening up the hips here and getting a little bit of space. Good stuff. Okay, feeling a bit looser, hopefully. Next one is one of my favorites. Up onto your knees on your mat. The foot, on the, let's go right leg, points away from you. So probably underneath the knee, maybe a little bit further away is fine because what you're gonna do is rock into that. So you're gonna really look to sort of open up the groin on that right leg. And just sink in. Again, just pushing it to the range that you've got. But this is a great hip opener, particularly specifically for the groins. And let's switch legs. So same on the other leg, just rock into it. Try to keep your hips as forward as you can, or shoulders at least.
Is your back toe up or it doesn't matter?
It's actually down, but I don't think it would matter too much.
Thank you.
Just relaxed as you can. Good stuff. And then the next one, same sort of movement, but the right foot is out in front of you and you're gonna rock forward this time. So again, get the leg far enough away so that the knee isn't coming too far over the foot. So if it's further away, that's fine. So that when you're in that position, you can really sit into that hip and hip flexor on the left leg. So I really like this as the start of a mobility, because you're really finding some space in kind of like almost unpressurized positions, not unstressful positions where you're not gonna feel like you're injuring yourself or you're not bouncing around trying to create that space. Let's switch legs. So then when we stand up, hopefully, you're gonna all feel like you've got a load of space in your hips. Okay, the next one we're gonna do, we're gonna come into a down dog position and we're gonna put the right leg up behind and bring it through into a glute stretch. If you've got the space, if your foot needs to come really close to your hip, that's fine. And then you're gonna step back, left leg up and come through. And you're just holding for a second or two and going back to your down dog position. This is always really good after a glute circuit as well, just to stretch off those glutes a little bit. And to activate the shoulders a touch too. Okay, last one. Good stuff. Okay, let's stand up. Hope everyone's feeling good after that. Next one, just to get our legs moving now, we're gonna do a crossover lunge. So crossover behind you and up to a high knee. So starting to get a little bit more movement through the body. Let's do two more. And we're gonna go into a squat to calf raise. So let's squat down and up onto the calves. Now I'm sure you've all done loads of squats, but make sure that that weight is through your heels, particularly thinking about how we just talked about through the heels. So the first motion can actually be to go back with the bum, sit into it and up into a calf raise. Good. Next one is single leg arabesque. So however you feel like you want to balance, and if you want to grab a chair or something, but you're just going to bend forward with the back leg behind and come back. Let's do eight. So really pin all of your weight through the full part of the foot, heel, ball, toes, bang. It becomes wobbly when we try to put too much weight on one part of our foot. Last one. And switch legs. Sort of starting to realize that maybe my glutes are a little bit stiff from playing squash yesterday. Good stuff. Okay, we're just gonna do a quick little pulse raiser. So we're gonna do 20 seconds each of triple squat. So we're gonna squat down, pulse for three, and stand up. We're gonna do that for 20 seconds. We're then gonna go into a set of star jumps for 20 seconds just to activate calves, get blood moving a little bit. And then the last one is some double-footed line hops. So imagining you've got a line like the T down there, and you're just gonna jump across and back for 20 seconds times three. Do I need to keep an eye on the chat?
Nope, I got it for you.
Great, fab. Okay, so 20 seconds. Let's start with our triple squat. Off we go. So squat down, pulse for three, and up. So just starting to get a little bit of movement now while we're stood on our feet into those hips and into our muscles. And we're going to go from here into our star jumps. Ready? Go. So nice and bouncy, nice and light. Push the floor away, up onto the balls of our feet. And from here, we're going to go into our double-footed line jumps. And off we go. So nice and light again. Keep them hips up, shoulders up. Five seconds, keep going. Stop there. Well done. Okay, we are in to a little bit more of the beef of the workout. So we're gonna do, as I said before, a squash specific type circuit, something similar to what you've done already with the other guys, but the difference is everything that I'm gonna say is gonna be focused on those pointers that I made at the beginning, heel toe, really throwing the leg out and keeping the hips up, staying tall, and making sure that you feel really light and efficient and rhythmical. And if it helps to think of your favorite player who you think moves brilliantly, just imagine that you're them. I did that all the time. So we're gonna go with a leg exercise and a plank exercise just to give your legs a rest, because I want you to really work hard. So we're doing 30 on, 15 off. We're gonna do drop lunges. So this is a perfect one for everything I just said about keeping up. So we're going to drop, feet together, drop. So this is the ideal one to not go drop down and then all of your effort back up. It's light, it's bouncy, it's using the back leg, it's keeping those hips nice and high to make it springy. Whoever said that in the chat, keep it springy and bouncy. And that's, then it's straight into a plank. Then we're going to do side squats. So we're keeping our feet nice and wide, and you're going to drop into a side squat. Now, the thing with the movement here is that I don't want to see this. So from the side, this is what I want to see. Not dropping down with the chest. So if you needed to kind of just in a squash motion keep up and take that at volley height, you could. It wouldn't be an issue, okay? So you're gonna drop in and out. That's into a side plank. And then we've got speed skaters, which is another perfect movement one for going nice and light. So what I don't wanna see is heavy placements here where you go, and then there's a split second before you jump and the chest, you see how my chest has gone? It's up, it's light, it's bouncy. So if I wanted to do that, and play a shot, I could. Then we've got the other side plank, and then we've got a nice little exercise that Phil Whitlock taught me, which is called crabs, where you're imagining you're on the tee and you're playing a little drop shot. Key is to hold your back leg on the tee. So it's open stance, hips up, chest up, firm body movement into another plank. And the last one is a repeater hop. So you're gonna lunge back behind and then jump up. So looking nice and tall, nice and light, hips up. Alrighty, someone grab the racket. Great, love it. Right, 30 seconds of work, 15 seconds of rest. It's about 6.5 minutes worth of work with obviously resting as well. So we're gonna go with drop lunges to start. I'm gonna take my top off. Okay, let's go guys. So I'm going to put you on gallery view and keep an eye on all this movement now. Keep up, keep tall, keep that back leg, use your back leg. Stay activated with that back leg, let it help you. Good, nice and light, think lightness. 5 seconds, think light. Stop there. Well done. Next one is our plank. So grab your mat if you need, for your arms. Okay, 2, 1, go. 30 seconds of plank. 10 down. 15 down. 20 down. 10 down. Well done.
I've got a bit of music going actually too, so try and put that on. Next one is our side to side squats. Okay, so we're gonna go in 2, 1, go. Drop down. So you're keeping your feet in the same position, really drop into that motion. Chest up, imagine you're playing a shot. That's better. Maybe even try and play a little drop shot type shot. That's like, nice Les. Good stuff. Feet wide. You got 5 seconds. Great guys. Well done, stop there. 15 seconds rest. Next one is a side plank. So 2, 1, go. You've got that. If you're super strong, you've got leg off too. And hold for 30. 10 done. The other option to do is leg down and reach in, reach under your arm if you want a middle ground. 5 seconds to go, doing great. I'm not falling off through a watch. And stop. Well done. Really good, guys. Next one is our speed skaters. So this is a great one for practicing this movement. 2, 1, go. So nice and light, use your arms. Try and keep the contact really short on the floor. And if I said to you, could you go forward for a drop shot? You could, because your hips would be nice and high and ready to go. Nice and bouncy, think bounce, think spring. Keep that contact light and short. There's some great speed skaters happening here. 2, 1, and stop. Other side of the plank, side plank. Doing great, guys. Keep strong. 2, 1, go. Hand on. 15 gone.
10 to go. Keep strong, guys. Keep firm. Come on, you got this. And stop. Great stuff.
Next one is our crabs. Such a cool name. Ready? 5 seconds, okay? So you are really keeping those hips up. Imagining you're playing a little drop shot. Let's go. Keep that back leg on the tee. Keep it rhythmical. Don't forget to keep them hips nice and high. Throw the leg out. Nice. Looking good, really good, guys. Good stuff, 10 seconds. Stop there. Brilliant, we're back to a plank. Two, one, go. Hang on. Twenty gone. And stop there. Well done. Okay, last one. Big effort on the legs. Same leg. For halfway, I'm going to tell you when to switch, okay? Repeat to hops. So you're going back and jumping up. Stay tall. Let's go. Use your arms. Keep them hips up. Don't sink in. Push off the back leg and drive up through the front leg. Let's switch legs. Come on, guys. You got it. It's tough on the legs, this. Let's go. Drive up. Well done. Keep going. 2, 1. Well done. Great set. Let's grab a drink. Really well done. Okay. Really good. I love it. I love the fact that, you know, when we're training, we're thinking so much more than just what are we getting out of this physically, because it can all link in so much if you just got your attention in the right place. So well done. Grab a drink. So, next one, we've got some fast feet. Yeah, so true. Staying strong. Well, I think what it does is when you've got something to focus on, it allows you to focus on it rather than how tired you are. And I always sort of thought that, you know, when I was playing, if I sort of got tired, it was the one thing that could pull me away from my tactical plan. I get tired, I can't think of my plan, which is why you need to be fit so you can concentrate. Okay, so we've got some fast feet. We've got 6 exercises of fast feet. Okay, I'm just gonna demo it while you grab a drink. We've got a skater hop to 3 high knee. So similar to what we just did, but your plan is to stick the hop, okay? So you're gonna hop, 3 high knees as fast as you can, and on the 4th, you're going to push off. So you're going to go 1, 2, 3, push off. So you're staying light, you're staying tall. I know I sound like a broken record. Fast feet, got it. Right, next one is our double-footed line hops like we did in our warm-up, but we're fired up now, so we're going to go for it. Okay, fast as you can. Next one is our squat and twist. So we are going to squat down, come up, twist behind. So that twist is fast. Shoulders stay forward, hips turn, just like you would on court. Next one is our over the line and 3 fast feet. So you've just got a short line, so we're not jumping, we're just a step over the line. 3 fast feet. Okay. Don't want to see squatty movements or heavy movements. Stay tall, over the line. If I said go forward, you could. It's all about quick rhythmical movements, okay? Next one is our forward lateral scissor jumps. So
you've got a lateral jump, forward jump, lateral jump, other forward foot. Fast. Okay.
And the last one, oh my God, I'm breathing,
is a split squat jump, but you're in a split position, you're gonna pulse for five. So you've got a little jump. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three.
You'll only get a couple of those in because it's only 20 seconds. Can I have round one off now? Okay. Okay, guys, so 20 on, 20 off, starting with our skater hop to three high knee. Okay, put my music back on. Let's go. Go.
Fast feet, stay light. Use your arms. Use your arms, come on.
Pump those arms. Helps the speed of the feet. Great, Michelle, that's good. Pump them, come on. Yes. Nice. Stop there, guys. Brilliant. Next is our double-footed line jump.
Ten seconds. So this is as fast as you've got for 20 seconds, and you get the same rest off. So go for it. Two, one, go. Stay tall. Nice, Emily. Good speed. Come on, guys, push it. Fast, fast, fast. 5 seconds. Stop.
Great set. Squat and twist is next.
Five seconds. Speedy hip turn. Push them hips in and out. Let's go. Go. Nice and low. Weight through the heels. Chest up. Stop.
Well done. Look great, guys. Really good. Next one is our over the line to three fast feet.
10 seconds. I feel like the rest starts to feel like it gets shorter. Keep going. Two, one, go. Keep going.
Use your arms, come on guys. When your arms move, your feet have to move. Great stuff. Two, one, stop, love it. Looks brilliant. Forward lateral scissor steps is next.
10 seconds. Speedy, you'll lose your way if you go fast, but try and concentrate. That's two, one, go. Stay tall, chest up, hips up. Keep going.
Nice and sprightly, keep going. Brilliant, stop. Great speed, Les, great. Okay, the toughest one of the set. Five jump pulses to three split squat jumps, and then we get a drink.
That is like a dance move. Okay, let's go. Five pulses, nice and light. Three jumps. Use the back leg, guys. Come on, remember. Use the back leg. Stop.
Great set. Well done. Grab a drink. Is everyone all right?
Breathing hard, but alive.
Great stuff. Okay, we're gonna do one more round of that, which I think will be great because you got to grips with the exercises there. So I bet you get quicker this time round, next time round.
Landing from the heel is sometimes difficult because we're so used to this time exercise is just landing whatever we want. That's good.
Yeah. It's just that, it's that the heel gives you that opportunity to really utilize the whole of the leg muscle, I think, to get you out. And the minute you come up onto your toe, you're trying to use all of your body weight on your big toe. A lot, you know, not quite, but there or thereabouts. So doing great, guys. Okay, so we are going to go in 15 seconds back to the top for skater hops and three high knee. I've got a sweat on. I'll get my music on. Okay, we're going in 6 seconds. 2, 1, go. Stay tall, chest up, don't sink down. Nice and light, remember? Hing across. Get that hang time, hang in the air. That's it, get some hang time. Then you know you're being light. Get knees high, stop. Great set, that looked great, brilliant. Over the line, double footed hops. Five seconds. Keep it sprightly, keep it fast. Ready, go. Push the floor away, come on guys, nice and light. Look speedy, love it. Stop. Well done. Next one is our squat and twist. So key here, squat down, fast twist. Shoulders forward. 5 seconds. 2, 1, go. Sit back onto the heels, guys. 5 seconds. Stop. Well done, team. Tough one on the legs, that. Doing great. Over the line, 3 fast feet. Sprightly, fast, light. You got it. Going in 5, 2, 1, go. Use your arms, head up. Well done. Forward lateral scissors. We're back to our dance move. Five seconds. So increase the speed if you can this time. Let's go. Nice and light. Up on your toes, heels off the floor. Well done. Last one is our 5 pulse jumps to 3 split squat jumps. So stay tall, chest up, hips fired. 2, 1, go. Keep going and we get a drink. Stop. Well done. Great set.
Good job.
I like that because it's it always feels like fun at least. So
using arms makes it a lot easier too. I really like that.
Using your arms.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure. It's great. Yeah. Someone once told me that running years ago, that when you pump your arms, your leg has to go, in time with your arm. So if you push, if you pump your arms, your legs have to go at that speed, which kind of makes sense. It'd be really hard to pump your arms fast and then get your legs to go slow. So yeah, that's why it's like almost a bit of a cheat, I think, if you can get those arms pumping. Good stuff, right. We got a little leg finisher, just because, you know, why not? So grab a drink. We've got 30 seconds of squats, 30 seconds of side squats, and 30 seconds of a lunge hold each leg, times two. So I'll be good. So really good. I mean, I think during lockdown, I've done a lot of holds just because it's a way to strengthen when I haven't got a great deal of weight in the house and stuff. I've literally got one 8K kettlebell and a 3K med ball, and that's all I've had all of lockdown. So it's been tough, but let's do some holds. So just as well, like from this workout, my idea behind it as well was just to give you guys some ideas behind, you know, stuff that maybe you haven't done before too. And yeah, as well, just before we get into this, I did a workout every Wednesday for 10 weeks in lockdown with my brother's fiance, who's in Philadelphia, and they're on my YouTube channel. So if anyone fancies a workout, they're great. I started from week one, 2 weeks ago again. So, okay, let's go with this then. Now we've got a breather. So 30 seconds of squats into 30 seconds of side squats. So the side squats are just going to be that wide footed position. So feet as wide as you can, sink in. The knee does not want to come past the toe. So if your feet are too narrow, you're not going to have the space. You see my knees already there. So you're there, getting them nice and wide and drop in, okay? But we're going to go first with some squats, 30 seconds of squats. Put my music back on. Okay, let's go, guys, 30 seconds. So sit back into those heels, make that leg, let them legs work. Squat down to 90 degrees if you can. Keep going, you've got 10 seconds. Don't know what's happened to my music. There you go. 5 seconds. And we're gonna go straight into our side squats. So we're gonna get a leg burn going here. So when we come into this next round, so we've got 12 seconds of this left, we're coming into a lunge hold. So this is where we're gonna think about those hips being high. And I want you to really think about distributing the weight between both legs. So let's go into that. Right leg forward, back leg down and bent. But the difference here is, even though I'm in a really, really deep position here, I haven't given up. I haven't sunk, and I haven't let all my chest go, and I've pushed the floor away, and I'm activated, and I have weight on my back leg, so everything isn't in the front quad. Okay, you got 5 seconds. Okay, let's switch legs. And then the perfect position probably for the hands is either on the hips or in front, as if you're playing a shot. Don't want to see sort of anyone on their front knee. I don't think anyone did, but that's sort of giving up a bit with the chest. Get them legs activated. Push away from the floor. Five seconds and we're coming back into our squats. So it's going to get challenging now. Going to squat again at your own pace. Nice and deep. Get some lactate into these quads, get some muscle growth going. Halfway. And we're going into our side squats, so let's get them feet wide and drop in. Get your range in your hips, looking good, really good. 10 seconds,
We're going back into our lunge hold with the right leg. And stop there. Let's go into our right leg hold. So chest up, hips up, equal weight distribution. Push the floor away, activate those glutes and hips. Really good stability, everyone, looks good. 10 seconds to go. Okay, let's switch legs. Well done. Last 15 seconds coming up. Keep that back leg activated. 3, 2, 1, stop.
Burn, leg burn. How's everyone feeling?
Feels good. Lots of thumbs ups.
Great stuff. So how are we on time? I had a core planned. Have we got time?
Thumbs how's up on core. Everyone's
got it. Some people are good for a bit of core. Dominique's already on her back, ready. Let's do it. I mean, I threw a little bit of core into the sort of first workout just to give our legs a rest, but I feel like we should do a couple of rounds. So basically planned, quite a simple one. It's 10 leg lowers or leg lifts, as you Yanks call them, much more positive than the Brits, leg lift instead of lowers. 10 reverse crunches. So I'll just give you a quick demo and then you can see.
So we've got our leg lowers. Hands are great here underneath the bum, just to support the lower back. Head's best resting on the ground, so you're not got any tension through your neck. Then reverse crunches. So again, hands can go underneath and you're just pushing your bum off the floor. And the next one is some twists. So if you've got anything handy, that's even a water bottle. This is just 3Ks, which is what, like 7 pounds maybe. You're just gonna twist. If you've got nothing, it's really not a problem. Just reach a bit further round and maybe take your feet off the ground. So we're gonna do 10 leg lowers, 10 reverse crunches, and 10 med ball twists. And then we're gonna go back to the top and do 20. So just 10 and then 20 and then done. Just a short little blast. Okay, right, let's go. 10 leg lowers. Rest your neck on the floor. Make sure your back's pushed into the ground. Last one coming up for me, and into our reverse crunches for 10. Reach them feet to the ceiling or to the sky. And then into our med ball twists. And then straight back into the top, 20 leg lowers. So hands under the bum again, head rested down for 20. Keep going, guys. Tough set this, 13 for me coming up. If it's too tough now, don't forget you've always got the single leg as an option. And we're going into our reverse crunches So 20, feet up to the ceiling. Ten down. Last one, and we're going into med ball twists for 20. Done.
You made it sound so easy.
No, that actually was burning a bit more than I anticipated. But, you know, I plan these things and then I forget we've actually got to do a workout before it.
I'm sure talking and also, like, using your breath at the same time is going to be much harder.
I know, but I'm also a lot more used to doing these sort of, like, sessions that I plan for myself. So really good, guys. You did brilliantly. Really impressed everyone. Everyone's form looked really good, and hopefully the idea behind it was to give you more than kind of just a workout, something to think on. I've been working with some of the England squash juniors around the same sort of thing, around, you know, you're in lockdown, you're doing a lot of these home workouts, but they can always have just that little bit more of a squash mind towards some of the exercises. And then, like you said, it goes quicker, it's easier, it gives you something different to think about other than the fact you're about to do another burpee.
No, thank you so much. This has been awesome. I really like the mindset, like you said, so that, you know, you can keep going through the exercise and think about getting a shot. So that's
I get asked a lot about my mindset when I was playing and stuff. And I think that the more that, you know, into retirement, the more I think about it, the more I start to realize how these little bits of things that I was doing really make a big difference. When you're doing them every day, twice a day, they distract you and they give you something to think about and you can focus on other things. And I think that was a big part of my mental strength. It's not just as simple as you're mentally strong. It's sort of like a distraction technique. It's like I saw Sam Cornette telling everyone, like, don't give anything away on your face. And I feel like that's such a huge tip as well. Like, you, if you can give away only what you want to give away, which was for me, like, my come-ons or whatever. I very rarely had a go at myself on court or showed much negative emotion. I think it really helps too. So yeah, I'm well done, brilliant.